Hey guys, Jeremy here from School of Wok Covent Garden. It's a Saturday special, This Girl Can Organise, and we're gonna show you the organisation of cooking a proper Asian family meal. We've got three dishes. We've got your coconut rice, we've got a Thai basil duck stir fry, and a Som Tam salad. Yummy. Nick's gonna do all the work. So, you cook a lot.
Yeah.
I know you're seriously organised, mm-hmm. and I'm a little bit nervous about this.
Really?
Yeah, because I just feel like, you know, you're going to be watching every move. How did you start? How did you start this Girl Can Organise?
I started This Girl Can Organise purely because I was made redundant.
Okay.
I used to work in investment banking,
yeah.
and I just wanted to do something new. I just wanted to do something that utilised all my skill sets, but at the same time was a passion of mine.
Right.
And organising has always been, underlyingly, my total passion. I've always done it subconsciously and not really kind of
I'm surprised that you're kind of not just moving these, but they have been very well aligned, haven't they?
Are.
Well, we're going for a full-on like three-dish meal because in Asian cooking, you never have like one plate, you know, per person. You usually have like, you know, two or three things at least that sort of combine together.
Cool.
I think what a lot of people maybe question is how you can organise yourself enough to be able to dish it all out hot at the same time.
That's the key.
Rice, biggest driver for our type of food. So when you cook your rice, what sort of rice do you cook?
I tend to have, well, we have quite a few different types. I love wild rice, brown rice.
Yeah.
But I do use Thai rice,
yeah.
Basmati rice,
okay.
And risotto rice.
And how do you do quantities?
Well, I tend to measure out.
Okay.
I do follow the rules.
Very organised. Yeah. I use my finger.
Do you?
Yeah. I'll show you.
Oh,
okay.
Cool.
But first things first is washing it because you really have to clean your rice. And I was I was taught that you always have to wash your rice at minimum three times. But if you wash it four times, it's unlucky. So it's either three or five or more.
Right.
So you can see how cloudy and bringing out all that starch.
Brilliant.
Like,
I never knew to do this.
Right. Exactly. So. There you go. I've taught her something already. Yes! So what we do is we really sort of massage it. Try and get as much of that cloudiness out as possible, which is after sort of the third, fourth, fifth time, you'll see that it's a lot clearer, the water.
Okay.
So a good number of washes.
Okay.
And then you can see how clear that is after sort of...
It's incredible.
I actually did five washes on that. Yeah. Obviously, clearer the water, the more separate the grains of rice once they're cooked.
Right, okay.
So we want that sort of slight stickiness, but more fluffiness in the rice. That's what's important, yeah. I'm going to get all that water out. Coconut rice, really, really simple. When you're cooking rice, as long as you've got the right amount of liquid, doesn't matter what the liquid is, mm-hmm. you know, we're gonna cook it nicely. So we're going to start and get a good amount of coconut water in there. And the stock is not there to like overpower it or anything like that. You can use chicken stock, vegetable stock, whatever you want.
Okay.
Now, there are different ways of measuring your liquid with your hands, okay, for rice. It tends to be that, and I've measured this by starting with my hands because that's what I know, and then I go to cups to put it into recipes, right?
Okay.
But the first way is that I was taught that in small quantities, halfway up the first line of your index finger,
okay.
Right, so that's, let's see, are they the same sort of size?
They are.
Yeah, see, that's funny,
that's
isn't
cute.
It? You got bigger hands than me, or they're about the same. Okay, so half for small people.
Small people.
Halfway up the first line of your index finger for small quantity of rice.
Okay.
There's another way as well, and it's your knuckles. So this knuckle here, right, if I press my hand into the rice, if it hits that top knuckle,
it's too much.
No, that's just right.
Perfect.
No matter what quantity of rice, that will work. Is that weird?
It's so weird, but it's good. I mean, right. It's messy, but it's hands-on cooking, isn't it?
It is, yeah. So I think it needs a little bit more liquid for that to be right. So I put a bit more chicken stock in, and now it's hit my top knuckle.
Okay, this is really, really
That's
amazing.
Fun, isn't it? Okay. Next up, we're going to bring it to boil, but we're going to season this as well. All right, so we've got some sea salt and a little bit of sugar, and you can just go for it. Just put a pinch in there, pinch of sugar in there, and that will completely change that sort of aroma of the rice, yeah? So, and the other thing is that we've got three dishes we're going to cook. Mm-hmm. So I've got my rice done first because we know that that's going to take the longest. Mm-hmm. Right? So that's my way of organising in the kitchen. But I think your version of organising is more about actually organising the kitchen, yeah. Right?
So yeah. For me, when I organise my kitchen or mm-hmm. clients' kitchens, it's all about zones.
Right.
So it's
zones, like what, like TFL zones or?
No, so it's about your cooking zone. Okay. So this is your zone here for the hob.
Yeah.
So I would expect everything around this hob area,
yeah,
you know, to be used as your theatre. So
right, okay, so wait, let me see, let me have a look.
Have a look.
Oh my God, don't look in there.
So the pots,
well, plates
the
are okay. Plates are okay, but maybe yeah. It should be. You're but right. Actually, at home, I've got pots and pans underneath my
hob. You have the pots
hob,
and pans, yeah. And I would imagine your utensils, your spoons, yeah. Your spatulas, okay. All to be nearby. So you're enjoying this whole
right.
Experience.
Ooh, can
you're
you smell that coconut?
Yes, I can yeah. Now. Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, so the zone. So you've got your cooking zone.
So cooking zone, and this applies and the, yeah. To everything. You yeah. Know, so for example, when you're making tea or coffee,
yeah.
Have your kettle, your cups. Your tea and coffee canisters all in one zone.
Yep.
Just makes that whole experience more enjoyable,
right.
And it's easy for everyone, whoever comes into your kitchen, to be able to use.
So we're in the zone, we're cooking our rice, you can see now it's vigorously boiling.
It smells delicious.
Yeah, right, once it's at that vigorous boil, you want to bring it right down.
Okay.
Okay, and that, at this point, you say, okay, yeah, you get it to the boil, but you then want to just allow that rice to sort of relax into the water.
Chill.
Right, so at this simmer, once it's got sort of gone down to that rice level, we'll switch it off, let it continue to steam.
Okay.
Right, whilst that's cooking, we can get onto your next dish. So Som Tam Salad, so you said you're kind of not scared of making salads, but it's not something that you necessarily do a lot.
No, I don't.
Okay.
Yeah,
is that because the kids don't like eating salad or?
They do like salads.
They do.
I just fear that I go to not put it, I go to prep it all, and
right.
Then when I go to put it all together, it just doesn't look as fabulous as.
Okay, well, Asian salads or Asian food in general is kind of like to throw everything in at the same time. And but that's what makes it beautiful, I think. So, Som Tam Salad, green papaya salad. If you can't find green papaya, you can swap it out with other sort of sour fruits.
Yeah.
And it's quite hardy fruits. So, like a sour apple, like a Granny Smith,
okay.
Would work really well.
Oh, really?
Yeah. And actually, we found coming back from Bangkok, that there's all different types of fruit that they use. Even star fruit is great.
I love star fruit.
You know, or there's this crazy sort of really sour fruit that we tried. We have no idea what name it is. It's got lots of different names. Apparently matong. So you can do this in a couple of different ways, right? So if you sort of slice into it and just sort of cut into it like this, right?
Yeah.
So I'll do half, you can do the other half.
Oh my gosh.
Okay.
These knives scare me as well.
Don't worry, just take your time, right? Right, so try and do the other half, just as I've done there, just across
okay.
To there. Yeah. Okay, that's it, take your time. That's it. Good. So we're sort of just preparing our strips of papaya, yeah. Right, good.
So much slower than you.
Yeah, that's fine.
But...
Right? Yeah. But it's looking good. Right, and then once you got to that point, then you can just sort of shave it off. You see that?
Oh my gosh.
How cool is that?
That looks lovely as well, doesn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, it does. There you go. And so you, if you're worrying about sort of making your salad look pretty, just the way you slice things does it for you. And you can see, you can do it a little bit quicker. And
wow.
Then once you get used to it, then it's nice and easy. And you can just sort of strip that off. So you've used good amount of your green papaya there, and it's all in nice strips, but quite quickly.
Yeah.
And the whole point is that the sort of seed or the pip holds it together for you, so you don't have to then worry about sort of slicing it twice, three times, or whatever to get to that point.
Okay.
Okay. So
yeah.
That's the main base of our salad. We've got other things already set up and prepped here, mm-hmm. So really we just have to make the sauce and sort of start to pestle and mortar it. So whilst our salad's going, our rice at a point where we can switch it off.
Okay.
Yeah. Right. It's had about sort of 5 to 10 minutes on a really low heat, and you can see now there's no excess liquid mm-hmm. in that. You can kind of lift it up and have a look. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Ideally, you don't want to do what I've just done there and lift off and release too much steam, because that steam is going to continue to cook that rice and fluff it up.
Wow.
Okay. So that off the heat, 15 minutes.
Fab.
Yeah. The whole time. So this is dish number two. Rice is on. Som Tam Salad. Now we're going to start to build up the flavour using the pestle and mortar. Mm-hmm. The beauty of Asian salads for me is that it's a salad, but it's still got a real punch of flavour.
Well, I can see all of these that are going in, and I'm just super excited because the flavours in all of them I love, and I would never think about making...
Something like this?
No.
Okay, all right. So do you like your chilli?
I love chilli.
Like, how hot do you take it?
Well, medium to hot.
Hot. Okay, so we'll use one of these chilies, I think, because this is a Thai bird eye chilli, so it's very, very hot. Mm. So we'll sort of slice into that. I'll let you do this. Just nice, fine slices of chilli. I always say that the three fingers in the middle, they're my crab, and then my little finger, they're my front legs of the crab. Mm-hmm. Little finger and thumb are my back legs.
Okay.
My back legs never go in front of my front legs, otherwise I chop them off.
Right.
Okay? Right, and then my right hand is always down and forwards.
Okay.
So nice sort of fine slices of chilli is all you need.
Massive chunks here, but I suppose...
That's fine. That's okay, because we're going to pound it anyway, okay? Okay, so garlic,
in
a little
water.
Trick is if you wet it before you bash it, give it a good bash, and then you should... just be able to pop it out. She likes that. That's it, get your weak sound going a bit more. Give it one big bash.
Oh,
yeah, that's
gosh.
Better, that's better. Then take the tip and flick it on the board. Just flick it on the board.
This tip,
yeah, that
here.
Tip there. There we go, look at that. Just take the ends off, any dry ends got to go. But we've got our pestle and mortar nearby, so we can start to sort of pile up the ingredients to keep our board nice and clean and tidy, okay? Finely chop your garlic, but again, because it's going into your pestle and mortar, it can be quite rough, this, because we're going to sort of pound that into the flavour of the Som Tam salad. We've got chilli, we've got garlic in there. These green beans here, they've actually been blanched in hot water for about 2 to 3 minutes already.
Mm-hmm.
So they're ready to go, ready to eat. The papaya can be raw. We've got some tomatoes here. I'm going to throw the tomatoes in because the juice from the tomatoes is going to create that sort of base flavour that perhaps people don't realise. Yeah, okay. To go with that, we'll start to add these ingredients here. We've got some tamarind.
Okay.
Right, so we're going to pour that tamarind into there. Natural sweet with some palm sugar.
Okay,
but I don't want it too sweet, so I'm going to put a teaspoon in first, and then we'll start pounding. So if you can start pounding that.
Okay.
Yeah, that's it.
Or...
twist and pound. You know, you go with the flow. You decide how you want to do it. So long as we get the juices out of those tomatoes, we're happy. Yeah.
Smells incredible.
So we've just got tamarind, palm sugar, garlic, chili, fish sauce going in there. Just go easy on the pounding here, just so that you don't sort of splash it all over yourself. So tell me about your book.
So, I wrote the book with HarperCollins, which was a massive honour and a massive shock too, because it's all happening, it's all happened very quickly. The book came out 3 months ago.
Yep.
It's doing ever so well.
Yep. What's it called?
It's called Mind Over Clutter.
Mind Over Clutter, guys. That's I like that. Yeah.
And it's a book... really, it's a go-to book, so it's not just about how to declutter.
Yeah.
I get some specialists in to help kind of talk about how I've seen the association of decluttering and how it affects your mental health.
Right, yeah.
In a positive way.
Yeah.
Which is lovely. And I wanted to share that information. And obviously, I wanted the book to be able to help others who... I guess couldn't necessarily have the time or couldn't, you know, get me into their homes.
Right, yeah.
So
you actually do go to people's homes and
sort them out. That's the business. That's basically, ultimately, the business.
Okay.
But the book also, one of my, I guess, top topics is eco-cleaning. I absolutely, you know, love it. I make all my own eco-products.
Yeah.
And it's really easy, so there's all recipes in there on how to make those. And then also another...
So you actually make them at home?
I do, yeah.
So can you give me an example?
I could give you... So something to clean your windows or your mirrors indoors.
Yeah.
So I get in some white vinegar.
Yeah.
So any kind of white vinegar.
Yeah, yeah.
Mixing it with water.
Yeah.
And then I add about 10 drops of peppermint oil, so essential oils.
Cool.
And it does the job.
Peppermint oil, what does that do to it?
Yeah. So it neutralises, so it's all antibacterial, yeah. All essential oils are.
Okay.
I tend to like using citrus oils like lemon, and it's just going back a little yeah. bit to, yeah. I guess, what our grandparents did, you know, we didn't...
It's quite similar, like when you're in a sort of a proper like chef kitchen,
it's a bit like
when you're cleaning the plates, we use vinegar to clean the plates.
There you go.
Vinegar and water to clean the plates. Okay, so you got a really nice sort of, almost paste out of that.
Nice.
Right, so you can taste, have a little taste of that. That's before any lime juice. And it's already got, it's got quite a powerful hit from that chili. But the tomatoes have that natural savoury flavour. And I only put like 3 to 4 teaspoons of fish sauce into that. But
that's
I actually think that's enough already. Yeah.
So easy.
So we're just gonna sort of accentuate that sourness with a bit of lime juice. And then let's try that again. So have a little. That's nice, isn't it?
Well, that's next level.
So the lime juice just lifts it.
Yeah. Yeah.
But look, we're using all natural flavours here. So, you know, I squeezed 2 limes. I didn't need all of it. Mm. It's good to sort of taste as you go.
Yeah. Yeah.
The next thing is we're going to start to sort of pound into a little of this. Obviously, it's quite liquidy. So at this point, it's almost just sort of crushing the green beans a little so that they sort of take in all that flavour. And then the same, again, with the Som Tam, with the actual papaya, the green papaya, we'll sort of throw it in there, give it a little press in, and we're pretty much there. Okay. And then we've got these dried little shrimp here. Yep. It's probably something that you don't really see very often.
No.
This is very, very classic to put some dried shrimp into
it's
that.
Funny.
And that works, yeah, I know, hello. and that works really well with that sort of fish sauce flavour as well. Your green papaya, I can, again, go straight into it. In England, this is seen as quite a big pestle and mortar.
I've got this size.
Oh, you have, yeah? But in Thailand...
They have huge.
They're like this big. So that you can get all of this into your sort of juices and the flavour.
Well, it's being used every day, I suppose. It is that essential item.
Exactly. Okay, so Som Tam salad's done. The stir fry, we've got to make a quick paste for. And then we're going to just make up my wok clock, which I think you've seen.
I know, I'm looking forward to seeing that.
And then the stir fry itself will take just a few minutes. And it literally, because it's so beautiful in itself, just pour it out, you know, just really sort of go for it. Pile it up, make it, you know, it kind of makes itself look pretty. Yeah.
It's beautiful.
Just sort of load that up to the centre there. And you can see, now we've just got some... I guess garnish with your dried shrimp.
Looks and smells incredible.
Yeah, I know. I mean, I'm
so
excited.
Easy.
Yeah, it's so easy. Yeah, all you need is a pestle and mortar. Yeah, okay, so some peanut. That salad, your balancing act, is ready.
Yeah.
Okay, rice done, salad done. All we need to do now is set up your stir fry. Now, so you'd think we've done this specially for you.
This looks gorgeous.
But like even like organising your sort of ingredients is quite useful for learning, I think.
Yeah.
And so this isn't even a wok clock. This is your paste ingredients. So we're going to do a Thai basil duck stir fry. And we've got all these finely chopped up ingredients ready to make into a paste.
Okay.
Okay. You could do this in a food processor if you wished. Yeah. I've got some Thai shallots, some chilli, and this stuff here... Try that if you want. That's a little bit of finger ginger.
Lovely.
It's kind of like a slightly bittersweet version of
the
ginger.
The smells here from this plate.
Yeah.
Oh, I mean, that's lovely.
Well, it's just super fresh, isn't it? Mm. Yeah. Right, so bittersweet from that. You can get that in Chinese supermarkets or Thai supermarkets. Some turmeric. That's fresh turmeric there.
Okay.
Just been sort of chopped up or pounded. Some galangal, lime leaf, lemongrass, coriander, and garlic. Coriander seeds, some toasted cumin, and some paprika.
Okay. And this is all called to reuse the pestle and mortar.
Look, yeah, absolutely. We're using fish sauce again. You know, all the same sort of base flavours are going into it.
Exactly.
So for me, I would just go for
makes
it.
Makes sense.
Yeah. Yeah, just really pound that.
This is good for aggression,
yeah.
No?
I know. Take out
got on your nerves today?
The kitchen's very good for removing stress.
Yeah,
right? So I'm just going to get all of these ingredients in there, and I just want you to pound that as much as you can. Don't worry about sort of breaking the floor or anything like that. So just go for it. Yeah.
Or the table.
Yeah, we've broken a few of those. Yeah. All right. Whilst you're doing that, I'm going to slice up a bit of pepper. So we want fine slices of pepper because I'm going to slice the duck as well. And we're just doing a very simple, natural duck stir fry. Okay, and whilst you're doing that, I'm setting up what I like to call the wok clock, right?
Oh, I can't wait.
I think you'll really like this. So the wok clock, any round plate at school of wok is perfect for us because we like your round plates to be a clock. So you start at 12 o'clock with your first ingredient and you go all the way around.
Amazing.
Okay, so once your paste is done, we're going to make your paste 12 o'clock. Then we're going to sort of load up with your duck and everything else. Yeah. So what we're doing over here is we're blanching your duck breast.
Right.
Right.
And how long will you do that for?
2 to 3 minutes. The whole point of it is to bring out its sort of fatty impurities.
Which makes sense.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. And you want to sort of tighten it up. Yeah. And then I'll slice into it. We'll finish it off in the stir fry.
And it doesn't lose the flavour.
No, it actually will make it add. It's almost it adds flavour because it tightens it up. When it hits the wok later on, it sears nicer and the skin will crisp up better.
Perfect.
Okay. My duck breast has been blanched, and actually I just popped it in a bit of cold water there just so that I can actually slice into it easily. And you can see it's tightened up properly, doesn't feel fatty at all, yeah? So I'm just going to slice sort of nice slices of duck out of that because we're actually going to cook this properly now in the stir fry. Right, if there's any just extra bits of skin like that, just take that out. Right, so my duck's there. We're going to give it a very simple marinade, yeah? We've got a little bit of turmeric.
Okay.
A little bit of sesame oil. Not too much. Some fish sauce.
Mm-hmm.
And a pinch of sugar. Okay?
Sugar is the key, isn't it?
Yeah, right, that pinch of sugar. I'll give this a quick sort of massage for you, obviously with the turmeric. I'd rather you not go home looking like you smoked 100 cigarettes. Okay, so... So we go, give that a good massage, and my duck is now ready to stir fry. Okay, so I'm going to pop that on my wok clock.
Okay.
The only other things we've got to do is get your sauce ingredients ready. The Thai basil comes in at the last minute.
Okay.
All it is now is a quick fry. It'll take 2-3 minutes. We're going to make this sort of medium hot, so I don't want it to go too hot. And the way to do that is just open up your chili like that, and then pop that at some point in your stir fry.
Amazing.
Okay, so I'll do two of those, but and because they're not finely chopped up, that heat won't sort of dissipate.
Take over.
Yeah. All right, so we've got two chilies, we've got your red pepper, your duck, we've got your beautiful paste that you've pounded incredibly well.
Thank you, Jeremy.
All right. Okay, so your paste can go at 12 o'clock on the wok clock because we want that to almost like flavour the oil that we're frying the rest into.
It looks incredible.
Right, so that's enough, I think. Two tablespoons. And I know you like your leftovers, so with paste like this, make a load of it.
And where can you store?
Freeze it in ice cubes. Yeah.
Liam,
and then once it's in the ice cubes, then you just take one out, then you've got it for... So you've done that work once and that's it.
Fantastic.
Yeah? Okay, and that'll last a few months there, yeah. And then your Thai basil's for the end, okay? So all we have now is your stir-fry sauce, which actually just comes from a very nice fresh chicken stock and some fish sauce. That's it. Right, so my wok clock is ready. Are you ready to wok?
I am. Let's do it.
Woo! Come on. Right, so wok cooking, I'll give you a few tips. You're going to do this, okay?
Okay.
Right, are you left or right-handed?
Right.
You're right-handed. Right hand on your utensil, okay? This is a specific wok ladle or wok spatula. Right, because the angle allows you to move into it easily, yeah?
Okay.
Right, okay, so you can sort of swirl, you can move, right? The next thing is it's high heat all the way.
Okay.
I'm going to give you 4 ways of cooling your wok down without having to faff around over here. Okay, the first way is the stir, all right? The stir fry, okay? Second way is a push and fold. Push and fold, push and fold. With your spoon down or your spatula down, not up, otherwise you throw it at yourself or me.
Of course. Yeah.
Okay, so push in, push in, push in.
Okay.
The third way is a wok toss.
Right.
I use my left hand for this, but you can use your right if you wish, okay?
Okay.
Wok toss, you pick your wok up,
yep.
Long push forward and a quick flick back.
Okay.
No shaky shaky, just nice and relaxed.
Isn't it funny? Because I do feel that my husband does the shaky shaky.
Yeah. There is a part where you need to sort of shake around, but not that point. The fourth way is what we call the tummy and head.
Okay.
Can you do that?
Hold
Tummy your head.
Am I now?
You're still patting yourself.
Patting around.
That's a pat and a pat. So tummy your head, round and round with your spatula, back and forwards with your wok.
Okay, we're going to give it a try.
Right, you're on the wok. I'm the ingredients putter in her. Okay. Are you ready to wok?
I hope so.
Okay. High heat, swirl that round.
Ooh.
Right, and just swirl it round with the base of your spatula. Good. Get it nice and even. Excellent. And we're going to start at 12 o'clock on the wok clock. Okay? When it's smoking hot, that is when we put your ingredients in. Okay?
Okay.
I actually think we've got a little bit too much paste in there, so I'm going to do that. And you can see we've used very little oil so far. Yep. Right, just push that paste to the back now, right to the back. Allow space for your next ingredient, your pepper. Okay, so your pepper is coming in. Three, two, one, go. And then bring.
Are you aligning sort of different types of cooking then? So by shifting up and down?
Yes, exactly. And you're just trying to sort of move the heat around. Can you see all that smoke?
Yeah.
If you see that smoke, first of all, bring that over the top so it doesn't burn, right? And secondly, at that excess smoke point, you need to give it a wok toss.
Okay, so
I'll show you one.
Yeah, go.
Right, I'll show you one. One, two, three, long push forward, quick flip back. Long push forward, quick flip back. Okay, try that. Okay, your turn. Yay! That's brilliant. Okay, good.
I'm doing it.
Okay, right, so at this point, we don't want to overcook your veg, right? You want to keep it nice and sort of crunchy. So push that to the back. We're now going to sear your duck, okay? We just need a little bit of oil. When that oil is smoking hot, that's when we put your duck in.
Right.
When your duck goes in, you want to sear with the base of your spatula.
Okay.
Yeah? Right, so smoking hot, your duck goes in, and then just push into your duck with the base of your spatula. Yep. Right, more like this. Push, 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 because we want to really give it a good sear.
Right.
Yep. Keep going. Now bring the vegetables over the top of the duck. That's it. And then now you're naturally working with that wok. So it's that nice sort of constant movement is really important when you're stir frying on a high heat like this. Yeah. Really, really smoking hot. Your two sliced chilies are going in. Right. Chicken stock. Ready? High heat. That's going to pour straight over the top there. And a little bit of fish sauce just to finish it off. And at this point, your Thai basil leaves straight in. Fold that through once or twice. Right, so it's really, really quick cooking. Right, that's the way we do it.
Beautiful.
And you can see now in our sort of 40 minutes or so, we've created three dishes, one whole meal. It's all about being organized, which I know you know. Okay, so your amazing wok skills, and you saw how quick that was. So you just dish that out.
It looks delicious. It's the smells, I think I'm overwhelmed.
Yeah, it's very like aromatic, isn't
beautiful.
It? And that's from the sort of spices from that pounding and that paste. Now I just like to pour that sauce over the top, and I quite like it nice and saucy because of the rice.
Mm.
You can use that sauce for the rice. Got some fresh Thai basil here that you can just sort of throw over the top, you know. So our presentation here for me is all around sort of the three dishes going together. So you've got your Som Tam salad, some rice, your coconut rice should be nicely steamed now, and you can if you just sort of fold into that,
that is
it's got a nice sort of coconutty flavour.
Learned so much today. This is so good.
I'm really pleased. Am I organized enough for you?
You are.
Okay, yeah.
You can come to my kitchen. Cook
well, we'll cook together at home. Yeah, that's not a problem. Yeah. So, your coconut rice, your sweet basil Thai duck stir fry, and your Som Tam salad.
Well done.
You want to tuck in?
I can't wait.
Let's go for it.
This looks fantastic. I can't wait.
Actually, try a little bit of that before you put anything else on it.
Yeah. Rice is one of my favourites. Oh my goodness me. That has to be the best.
Yeah.
The flavour is absolutely delicious, but it's light, it's fluffy, it's...
Exactly, yeah. Yes. Right, so, and then your salad, which you said you're not sort of, you don't usually sort of make that often, but that goes really nicely with the rice. So, and then your duck. How good is that?
It is so beautiful. Do you want to move in my house?
Sure, no problem. Just ask my wife. All right, so we've got your duck and your Thai basil. It's always nice to get a bit of that sauce as well. Do you want some sauce? Yeah. How good is that? Well, I'm liking the reactions.
And the chili, like the hit, the chili, that is perfect for me. Because I love it medium hot. And this is...
That's bang on, isn't it?
Beautiful. I cannot believe the time that's taken to cook.
Wow.
That's so easy. And
if, we weren't filming, it would take half the time.
I can imagine. Yep. But like, in terms of like Saturday night, this is a perfect thing to do Saturday afternoon.
Yeah. Yep.
Chilling, cooking with the kids.
Yeah.
Everything's all prepped. And you can see, like, once we've used everything, it's all gone in the dishwasher, all gone to be clean.
Mm.
And this beautiful dinner.
As you can see, guys, we can't stop eating it. I'm pretty sure you won't when you cook at home. This girl really can organise, and I love every minute of it. We can't wait to see you guys. Don't forget to subscribe to our channels.
Yes. See you soon.